In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Gracias a Dios. Besides you who have the care of all, that you need show you have not unjustly condemned. Your might is the source of justice. Your mastery over all things makes you lenient to all. For you show your might when the perfection of your power is disbelieved. In those who know you, you rebuke temerity. But though you are master of might, you judge with clemency, and with much lenience you govern us. For power, whenever you will, attends you. And you taught your people by these deeds that those who are just must be kind, and you gave your children good ground for hope, that you would permit repentance for their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Quam admirabile est solentum in universa terra, quodiam elevata est magnificentia tua super celos.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit comes to the aid of our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought, but the Spirit himself intercedes with inexpressible groanings, and the one who searches hearts knows what is the intention of the Spirit, because he intercedes for the holy ones according to God's will. The word of the Lord.
God.
Amen.
the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus proposed another parable to the crowd, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everyone was asleep, his enemy came and sowed weeds all through the wheat and then went off. When the crop grew and bore fruit, the weeds appeared as well. The slaves of the householder came to him and said, 'Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? Where have the weeds come from?' He answered, 'An enemy has done this.' His slaves said to him, 'Do you want us to go and pull them up?' He replied, 'No. If you pull up the weeds, you might uproot the wheat along with them. Let them grow together until harvest. Then at harvest time, I will say to the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles for burning, but gather the wheat into my barn.' He proposed another parable to them. 'The kingdom of heaven is like a mustard seed that a person took and sowed in a field. It is the smallest of all the seeds, yet when full grown, it is the largest of plants. It becomes a large bush, and the birds of the sky come and dwell in its branches.' He spoke to them another parable. 'The kingdom of heaven is like yeast that a woman took and mixed with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch was leavened.' All these things Jesus spoke to the crowds in parables. He spoke to them only in parables to fulfill what had been said through the prophet, 'I will open my mouth in parables. I will announce what has lain hidden from the foundation of the world.' Then dismissing the crowds, he went into the house. His disciples approached him and said, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field.' He said in reply, 'He who sows good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, the good seed the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. Just as weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin and all evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears ought to hear.'"
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As we continue in the Archdiocese reopening plan during this time, thank you for your patience with the necessary health requirements. The guidelines of the Archdiocese of Chicago ask that people receive communion in the hand during this time. When approaching for communion, please follow the directions of the ushers and maintain the proper social distancing for those who are not members of your family. In order to accommodate people for masses in the limited attendance, we have added a Sunday 5 p.m. English Mass. Please sign up for this or any Mass you attend on our website. As you can see, the restoration of the Shrine of Our Lady of Fatima is nearly complete. Finishing touches will be done this week. We have received gifts that cover just about half of the cost, and we thank you for your generous support. If you would like to participate in the restoration of the shrine, please make your check out to AMDG Foundation and place it in the offering baskets or send it in the mail. Mark your check Our Lady of Fatima Shrine, and further details are in this Sunday's bulletin. RCIA classes will begin Saturday, September 5th. See the bulletin for details. And confessions are being heard in the church basement today. This Mass is offered for deceased Albert Zigleski and for President Trump and his administration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, The hidden things are often most powerful. But we tend to focus on what is visible, what is powerful in this world's eyes. Remember, as a teenager, working to form leaven as they would have back in the time of our Lord. In other words, taking simple, hand-crushed grains of wheat, mixing them with water, and then taking this small amount of dough, just water, just wheat, and placing it within a large barrel of ground wheat, and leaving it within a certain degree of temperature in the basement. I would check on it every day, and lo and behold, after about 10 days, on the top of the surface of the flour, you could see a little crack formed. That little ball of dough was coming to life. This was the leaven, and when that leaven was mature, I could take a very small amount of it and mix it into a large batch of fresh dough, and the whole batch of it would be raised and would have that delicious yeast flavor. It's something very small. It's something very hidden, and yet it permeates the whole. Our Lord offers us three parables in this gospel. The first one, rather long, the weeds and the wheat. Then the shorter one, the mustard seed. And finally, the leaven, which is just one sentence long. What about that first one? Because they all deal with hidden realities. When the weeds and the wheat are growing up together, his servants say, "Master, should we go and pull the weeds?" And he says, "No." And there's a specific reason for this, because the particular type of weed being mentioned is darnel, which is very, very similar looking to wheat. In fact, it's hard to tell the difference until they are fully mature. So the risk is, don't go out there and pull the weeds, because you might accidentally pull up something which is good. You can think of St. Augustine's commentary on the psalm when he says, "Never hate another person, because you might be hating your brother without knowing it." And he says, evil men are put in this world in order that they may be converted, or in order that they may try the good. So we cannot look at people and judge them and say, well, this one is a weed and that one's wheat, because often you can't tell. This is a hidden reality. I wonder how many looked at Mary Magdalene and said, oh, what a weed, we should pluck her out. And yet our Lord said, she has loved much. What about the great Saint Augustine himself? Certainly a nasty weed, and yet beautiful wheat, very fruitful. Saint Peter, or what about all of those sinners that our Lord chose to associate with so frequently, the tax collectors and the prostitutes? Surely we look and say, that's a patch of weeds, and yet really it turned into beautiful wheat. It's a hidden reality. What about the mustard seed? He says it's the smallest, most insignificant, the type of thing that might accidentally stick to your fingers, or that you might accidentally let drop to the floor. It's so small and insignificant, you'll walk right by it and not even notice it. And yet the farmer goes and places it in the ground. The church fathers say this mustard seed is a symbol of the passion, placing in the ground the symbol of our Lord's death. And yet, I don't know if you've ever taken a mustard seed and just chomped down on it, pop it in your mouth and chew it. It's explosive. The flavor is so intense. The aroma is so intense. This is just like the passion. When something which looked very insignificant in many people's eyes released an amazing fragrance, the grace which has overtaken the world. Often enough, in ancient Roman basilicas, they'll depict the cross as a beautiful vine with branches and fruit going all over the apse, as a symbol of this little mustard seed, which when crushed, fills an entire space. It's small, and we overlook it, and yet it is so important, just like the leaven, a small amount, and yet it fills the whole space. This is God's way of working. He doesn't work with the big mass media, not with explosions, not with big movements or violence, but with the very smallest things. And think of Mother Teresa
who did so many good works, but yet she said it's because of the interior life. She would describe her prayer as pushing down into her heart until it hurt. So moving from these three parables, from the one of many words, the parables of the weeds and the wheat, to the little mustard seed, to the leaven, this gospel invites us to take on a spirit of silence and patience, just like you have to wait for that leaven to begin to germinate. Just as our Lord comes to us in the Eucharist, and for Max, this will be his very first time to receive Holy Communion today, and what a joy for our entire parish to get to witness your first communion, and a reminder for all of us what a powerful mustard seed the Holy Eucharist is when it finds root in our heart. There are many visible realities in the world, but the hidden ones are the most important. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was in the incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence in our Father, we present our petitions to him. For all leaders of the Church, especially our pastors and religious superiors, that they may lead us to appreciate and ponder the hidden mysteries, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who put themselves in harm's way for our protection, especially our first responders and those in the military, that God may protect them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to holy orders and religious life, especially to the canons regular of St. John Cantius, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for those who have died, that they may rest in peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, we present these, our petitions, before you in faith through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let me
the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honor of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. Boundless glory, that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we are clear.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus.
So that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Blaise our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.